Today I will show you one easy way to improve your deploying. If you're a full stack developer like me, you have to do a lot of other stuff than writing your source code. One important part is to update the version after you have changed the source code. That sounds really simple, but if you forget this, there's no new version. You can write the best bug fixes or new features if you don't set up the new version. No customer will know it. On the other hand, for you as a developer, it's really important to know the changes inside your source code. One way is to write comments to every change inside your source code, but this will destroy all the structure. It's really outdated, you shouldn't do it. Git allows you to tag some point in your repository history to be important. This is the most common way to document changes inside your source code. Let us take a look in the project for my last video, imgflip. If you look on the GitHub page, you see there are no tags. But as you remember, we already created the version 001. So before we change the source, we will tag this version number to the current stage of the repository. I know there are some nice GUI for Git, but I will do it in the terminal. There are two types of tag, a lightly and an underloaded tag. You should always use an underloaded tag. So let's simply create a tag. That was really simple, right? Now we have to push the new tag to GitHub. Keep in mind that the git push command don't push the new tag. You have two options to push a tag to the repository. The first one is to specify the tag with git push and then the tag name. The second way is to use the tags option to push more than one tag to the repository. Now the tags are available for everyone. Before we came to the funny part, let us look inside the setup script. There you can see we have to define the version number. And if I change the source code and make a new release, I have to update the version number in the setup script. There are now two places where we have to edit the version, one in Git and one in the setup script. But there's already a third place I forgot in the first video. Every Python packet should have a version string inside its source code, so you can get the version number at runtime. So let us simply fix this problem. This is really simple. Inside the init file, we defined a variable with the version string. So now if we try it again, you see we get the version string at runtime. So now the question, how we can avoid this multiple version string, avoid the whole project? There's one way where you can write one file with a version string and include it in the other files. But then you still have to use git to tag the version. There's one great Python package called setups-tools-scm, which will help you. With this package, you can use the tags from Git as a version number inside your packet. So you don't have to specify a version string inside the project or the setup script. You only have to tag the repository and that's all, and you'll be happy. And it's really easy to set up. You only have to add these two lines inside your setup script. To make the version a variable at runtime, you have to change the init file. You can simply copy and paste this example inside the init file and change the package name. As you can see, the version looks a little bit weird, but this is only the case if there's no tag. If you tag the changes, the version looks quite nice. For me, that was a big improvement to my workflow. I don't have to remember all the different version strings. I only have to set a tag on Git and I'm done. To make this even more interesting, I have set up Jenkins and automate all the stuff. So I don't have to build the packet and upload it on the update server or on PyPy. I only have to commit my changes to GitHub and then my build server will do the rest for me. This is maybe stuff for a further video. I hope you enjoy this video and learn something new. please like and subscribe, and if you have any question, write a comment, I try to answer. See you next time.